The best time for Duxford is either the first thing in the morning when you turn up for work or last thing at night when everybody's gone home, because there's a certain atmosphere or buzz about it. When it was operated by the Americans, it was the only station that they could actually take off 8 aeroplanes line abreast. And sometimes you look across there and you think, well, you know, the guys were doing this for real 50, 60 years ago. You know, they would see their aeroplane off and it wouldn't come back. Not to glorify it or sugarcoat it in any way, but these things did happen. Every year, more and more people aren't there who remembered or who were there. And the thing that runs right the way through it is the aeroplanes. So when us as a generation, when we finish maintaining them and flying them, there'll hopefully be another generation that will still be there who've got the interest and the passion to carry on operating and flying these aeroplanes.
I think one of the things that's special about the Duxford Field is the fact that it's an old World War II base, and the photos that you see of the 78th Fighter Group from World War II can be transposed on where we were and where we are. The first thing that I recall was taking off. I went a couple miles away just to use the airplane, and it put color to all the World War II footage that I see. Because here I am, raging around the UK in a Mustang, which so many guys did 60-some years ago. You see all the gun camera footage or all the movies, and it put color to all those. That's the first thing I thought about. I was like, wow, this is really, really cool.
It's like just being in a time machine. And you can just absolutely visualize what it must have been like for the real Mustang pilots. It really became this unbelievable celebration of the people through the Mustang. And even more so, those people that rode those magnificent aircraft and fought in the war and gave their lives so that we could all have the lives that we have now. You can't help but do that and not be reminded of the great bond that the Americans and the Brits had together during the Second World War. We took this aircraft, the Apache, and we had Allison engines in them back then, sold them to the Brits, and the Brits started tinkering around with it and decided that it needed some more horsepower, and they put this unbelievable Rolls-Royce Merlin engine in it, and suddenly the Apache became the Mustang that it is today. And it's just kind of it's this genetic bond that's been there from days gone by, and it's still there, and it means a lot to both of us. So there we are, Jimmy, Dan, and myself, Tom Freakin in the back of Dan's airplane, our mentor and coach. And in the back of my airplane, I had this guy named James Horner. And James, for those people that don't know, is one of the world's most renowned composers for feature films. Go watch Titanic or Braveheart or more recently Avatar. James is a pilot, and he is, we call James the Fourth Horseman. You know, England is where James is from, and it's where he learned to fly, and he did his first flying lessons, and he gets England, and he gets the history, and he understands these airplanes way better than I do. He's been with us almost since day one, as we've trained for the three ship, flying in the Mustang, taking notes and videotaping and just kind of drinking it all in as he's been working on composing some music for us for the Horsemen. And he is about the only person that we know that can sit in the back of the Mustang during the Horsemen routine and not get sick. He just loves sitting in the Mustang, flying across the English countryside, his old home. We're really looking forward to the time when we fly to the music that James has composed for us, because we know deep down that James is the only person in the world that can really emote the soul of what we feel about it all. At air shows all over the world, there's normally a single individual who's kind of the powerhouse behind the event. And at Duxford, that person is Stephen Gray.
James Horner, Stephen Gray.
Oh, hello. How are you doing? Pleasure to meet you.
How are you doing?
Simply put, Stephen Gray is a piece of work. He's an unbelievably brilliant guy. He knows everything there is to know about World War II aircraft. And then on top of it all, he flies like all get out. Stephen is just connected to that place. They have a deep, keen appreciation of the location and a total respect and reverence for the history of it all.
This is such a historic place and such a beautiful place, and just to be able to fly off of this grass is a real privilege.
Being an American and going to Duxford to participate in the show and being invited to come for America, it is obviously a big privilege. That's a big deal. It is something that I try to be mindful of, and I try to be respectful of it.
For us to be able to go to Duxford and fly P-51 Mustangs off that grass, the same grass that all those young men in the Second World War flew off, it's just surreal.
Having Dad here and knowing how important this stuff is to him, and knowing that I'm doing this as a third generation pilot and a family of pilots, being able to do it here and knowing that my grandfather was operating in England during the war, that a bunch of years ago he was flying over the same geographic areas that we flew over yesterday in P-51 Mustangs. Of course, he was flying Spitfires, but. It's really a special feeling.
This is a very historic World War II fighter base, and I think that gives it a certain ambiance. And I think because we're not elitist, but we're purist in the selection of aircraft that participate, we don't have jets at all. Now, some want to go to a more rounded air show. Ours very much features on World War I and World War II. And I think what we've done over the years with the Flying Legends brand is consistently delivered.
An awful lot of air shows may well advertise an 8-hour flying display, but that's 8 hours with gaps in. Duxford does a 3.5-hour flying display, and basically what we aim to do is that for every second of that 3.5 hours, there is something moving in front of you in the sky.
It is such a concentrated collection of history combined with a population that really gets it. I mean, I would bet that almost everybody in Great Britain knows what a Spitfire is.
I've been coming since I was a little nipple like my brother, around about 5.
The sheer quality of flying an aircraft here is just outstanding.
I just love aeroplanes, actually. I'm an engineer, and I think aeroplanes are just the best of the engineer's art.
You get to Duxford, and it's like going to the Kentucky Derby, and it really is. Combine that with the people that are there. You know, Stephen Gray is such an interesting guy. You know, we've made a lot of close friends, from pilots to maintainers to everybody there who's involved in keeping the operation pointed in the right direction.
Well, I thought we did miraculously well. Having paid in advance for the weather, I'm glad it turned up.
You want to see the horsemen, without a doubt. I mean, these guys have traveled a long way to come here. They're flying three beautiful Mustangs, and you won't see that anywhere else in the UK this year.
They stand out as different right from when they actually do the engine start, because almost like the engine start is choreographed, right to they taxi out, they take off, then the whole thing is just as one, the whole all the way around the routine.
When we go do the air show at Dux, it's the most important place that we could ever fly P-51 Mustangs. And you got to remember that for us, the damn Yankees that are coming over from America to go to this unbelievable place, it's a completely humbling experience. The reason why it is so special is because of what it means. It's not just an air show location, it's a memorial. That very grass that you taxi across, that grass that you sit on, those hillsides that you see in the distance, it's all exactly the same. You can't help but be struck at what a wonderful thing that you've just been involved in, and what a spectacular place Duxford is, and what it means not only to yourself, but what it means to everybody. Not just people there, but nations, entire nations, and the gratitude that they have for what these guys did in the Second World War.
Be able to do it, and to be able to do it with them and be a part of the team, integrating Warbirds and Precision Acro, which I love, and doing it with horsemen is something that I never thought I'd be able to do or achieve. And so I have to not think about that too much when I'm in the formation. I just have to stay in position and try not to move. But if you think about it enough, it's pretty incredible to have this experience. We'll be right back.
information is coming into my head had come into guys that flew these airplanes for real 60 years ago, and I was getting the same data, if you will, in large measure, that they were. I'm here pretending, but a lot of these guys are coming back in all types of weather and all conditions of health, and for both personally and with the machine. And we were able to experience that same, at least, visual that they would have had, which, I don't know, I can't really describe it other than saying it was really cool.
And so from the horsemen to everybody at the Flying Legends Airshow at Duxford, the people on the ground watching, the guys that take care of the aircraft, Stephen Gray, Nikki Gray, Jane Larkham, everybody who makes it happen, all we can say is thank you.